Hi team, this is Chris Abraham from GOHmath. Today we're doing a new problem as part of GOHmath's 2015 Teacher Workshop Series. Let's look at it first. I'll read it over, and then we'll go about solving it. It says here, use the diagram below to answer the question that follows. And then they give you a diagram. And then they have this question here. Why don't you take a moment and just pause the video. Pause it right now. And actually scan this over, look at the picture, read the question, look at the answers. Unpause it. Okay, well, what'd you see? Well, sometimes it's good to slow this stuff down. And I want you to sort of see that this problem here has three major sections. It has a diagram, and the diagram gives us a clues to what the problem's gonna be. Like, just looking at this diagram, I'm thinking it's a geometry problem involving rectangles and triangles, maybe involving perimeter, possibly involving area. Well, the question gives us information. It says here, which of the following expressions shows the correct procedure for calculating the area of the shape shown above? So right away we're thinking, hey, this is a geometry problem involving area. So it's a geometry problem involving area of a rectangle and triangle, and then the answer choices. Well, the answer choices aren't actual answers to the problem. They're the expression that would represent the answer or the area of this shape here. So this is a nice way of seeing how on these new exams, you're not actually gonna have to find the area of these two-dimensional shapes. You just need to find the expression that represents the area. And this means it's gonna be a little bit trickier. But here, let's work with these ideas that we're working with here. We're trying to find the area of rectangles and triangles. So I'm gonna use my background knowledge in geometry on rectangles and triangles, and I know a rectangle, the area is length times width. So in this case, in this rectangle, you know, it doesn't really matter what you choose for the length or width, but we could choose, you know, 4 as the length and 7 as the width. So why don't we do 4 times 7 here? This expression here represents the area of that rectangle. And then we have a triangle. Now, a triangle has a different formula. What is it? Try and remember. 1/2 the base times the height. That's one way of thinking about it. Well, 1/2 the height, that's not that bad. That's 4. The base, it doesn't directly give you the base, but I think it's pretty fair to say on these problems, when you know this is 7 and this whole thing is 9, this little piece has to be whatever 9 is minus 7, right? Because this could be 2 plus 7 gets you 9. That kind of gets us that last dimension, that base of 7. So it would be 4 times 7 plus 1/2 4 times 2, or 4 times 2. Sort of working through this, here's the area expression for the area of a rectangle. Here's the expression for the area of the triangle. And kind of like, you know, working with these ideas, we can get to C as the answer. All right, team, this is Chris Abraham from GOHmath. Have a great day, team. Take care. Bye-bye. Hi, team, this is Chris Abraham from GOHmath. This spring and fall, we're hosting a whole brand new series of workshops for teachers for math, science, English, and history. You should check out these workshops. We're going to be holding them in Massachusetts, in Florida, in New York, in California. Check them out. I'm sure you'll find them very helpful. Take care. I'm the walls kept tumbling down in the city.